Hi everyone, I'm Mel, an illustrator and surface pattern designer from Wellington, New Zealand. Today I'm going to show you how to wrap a pattern design around a complex object to create a mockup in Photoshop. For this example, I'm going to be taking a photo of a box, and then in Photoshop I'll show you how to use the vanishing tool to wrap a pattern around it. Now, one thing to note with this way of wrapping a pattern around a box is that you can't create a smart object, which are great for creating mockups that you can use over and over. So I'll show you how to do that in a later video, but for the moment I find this to be a very quick and easy way to create a simple mockup using a complex object. So I've got this little white box here that I am taking a photo of. I've just put it on my kitchen bench and I have place some eucalyptus around it just to make it a little bit more interesting, and I want to get it so that it's at an angle so I can see both the top of the box and the side of the box. So that's looking pretty good. I'm going to open that photo in Photoshop. Okay, so I've got my photo in Photoshop and I have a pattern over here that I want to place onto the box. Now, the good thing about the vanishing point feature is that I can wrap my pattern around the edges of the box so that it looks like it is actually wrapped around it rather than just flat on the box. So it creates a more realistic mock-up. So the first thing I want to do is create a new layer. And then I'm going to go up to filter and then vanishing point. Now in here we're going to create the plane on which the pattern is going to sit. So if you look over here on the left, this icon here is selected. That's the create plane tool, and then we are going to just map out one side of the box. So I'm going to just click on this edge and then to that edge and then to the side and then back down. And if you haven't got it quite right, you can use the little boxes here to drag it out and fix up where you want it, and it's best to do this as you go and not at the end. So let's just move that out a little, and then we want to drag it across the top of the box. And to do that, I'm going to hold down the command key on a Mac, and I think it's control on a PC, and then click and drag, and just to the end there. And then if I let go and just click on the individual squares there, I can drag it out to the right spot. And then let's pull this one in. Try and get it as accurate as possible. And then again, we want to do it on this right hand side here. So I'm going to hold down the command key and then click and drag. Okay, that's looking pretty good. So all I need to do is click OK. And then I'm going to go over to my pattern file here. I'm going to click on command A to select, or you can go up to select and select all. I'm going to command C to copy and go back to my mockup, then go back up to filter, vanishing point. Now in here I need to click out in order to paste it on so that you don't see the grid, and then I'm going to paste, command V, and it's just placed it across the whole entire thing, which is fine. Okay, and then all you need to do is just drag it onto your box, and you can see it's snapped into place there. And when you're happy with the placement, just click OK. And at the moment it doesn't look that good, we can't see the edges of the box. So to fix that, all we need to do is change the blending mode. So over here in the layers panel, I'm going to select multiply, and now you can see that the edges have come through. We can see the gap in the box here. And it looks pretty good. It looks like it's wrapped around quite nicely. I think I probably would have spent a little bit more time on the plane just to fix up some of the edges, but I think you understand how it works. The other thing I like to do is when you use the multiply, it may adjust the coloring and it's looking a bit dull at the moment. So I'm just going to add a brightness contrast layer and just change the contrast a bit. And you can see that just bringing it out a bit, maybe a bit of the brightness. And I'm pretty happy with that. I might also add a hue saturation and just up the saturation a little bit, which will bring out the colors and the lightness. Let me just bring down that saturation, it was a bit too high. Just a touch. And there, that's looking pretty good. So thank you for watching my video. I hope that it was really useful for you and I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. Also, let me know if there is a video you want me to create, as I'm always looking for more ideas and I love to answer your questions in regards to illustration and surface pattern design. And consider liking and subscribing if you haven't done so already so that you're notified of my videos. And I'll see you next time. See you later!